Welcome to chapel. As we begin, remember the words of Isaiah 43:11. I am the Lord, and besides me, there is no Savior. Today we are going to be studying the name Yahweh Shalom. This means God our peace.
Now you might have heard the word Shalom before. It's sometimes used as a greeting or a word of farewell. But at its deepest meaning, Shalom means that you wish someone completeness, wellness, safety, and perfection. This is an amazing kind of peace, a peace that our soul craves, and this peace we can only get from God.
We begin this chapel in the name of the Father, who gives us peace, in the name of the Son, who is the Prince of Peace, and in the Holy Spirit, who sustains our peace. Amen.
Please pray with me. Dear Jesus, thank you for setting aside this time for us today to worship you and be in your presence. Please calm our hearts and minds and help us rest in your presence for the next half an hour. In your holy and precious name we pray. Amen.
Our first song today repeats the name of Jesus over and over. If you're ever feeling a lack of peace in your life, just try calling on the name of Jesus over and over. Please stand and sing.
Surrounding me, let it break at your name. Still, call the sea to still, the rage in me to still, every way at your name. Jesus, Jesus, you make the darkness tremble.
Yahweh Shalom wants to give us peace every moment of every day, but sometimes we look to the things of the world to give us peace. Please join us in reading today's confession.
God, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We confess that we have looked to things of this world for peace instead of turning to you.
Please forgive us and take away our sins. Teach us to turn to you every moment of every day. Amen.
Now hear the good news of the absolution. Yahweh Shalom has heard your confessions and he forgives all of your sins. Now Psalm 103 verse 12 says that as far as east is from the west, so far does God remove our transgressions from us. Have peace and rest in knowledge that your sins are forgiven.
Today's Old Testament reading comes from Judges 6. In this chapter, we see people who are so far from peace as possible. Before this passage, the writer explains that the Israelites have been oppressed by the Midianites for several years.
In their suffering, they called out to God. In response, God raised up Gideon to lead them out of oppression. Watch as God brings Gideon peace long before the circumstances could be considered peaceful.
And the angel of the Lord appeared to Gideon and said to him,
"The Lord is with you, O mighty man of valor."
And Gideon said to him,
"Please, my Lord, if the Lord is with us, why then has all this happened to us? And where are all his powerful deeds that our fathers recounted to us, saying, 'Did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt?' But now the Lord has forsaken us and given us into the hand of Midian."
And the Lord turned to him and said,
"Go in this might of yours and save Israel from the hand of Midian. Do not I send you?"
And he said to him,
"Please, Lord, how can I save Israel? Behold, my clan is the weakest in Manasseh, and I am the least in my father's house."
And the Lord said to him,
"But I will be with you, and you shall strike the Midianites as one man."
And he said to him,
"If now I have found favor in your eyes, then show me a sign that it is you who speak with me. Please do not depart from here until I come to you and bring out my present and set it before you."
And he said,
"I will stay till you return."
So Gideon went into his house and prepared a young goat and unleavened cakes from an ephah of flour. The meat he put in a basket and the broth he put in a pot, and brought them to him under the terebinth and presented them. And the angel of God said to him,
"Take the meat and the unleavened cakes and put them on this rock and pour the broth over them."
And he did so. Then the angel of the Lord reached out the tip of the staff that was in his hand and touched the meat and the unleavened cakes. And fire sprang up from the rock and consumed the meat and the unleavened cakes. And the angel of the Lord vanished from his sight. Then Gideon perceived that he was the angel of the Lord. And Gideon said,
"Alas, O Lord God, for now I have seen the angel of the Lord face to face."
But the Lord said to him,
"Peace be to you. Do not fear. You shall not die."
Then Gideon built an altar there to the Lord and called it, "The Lord is Peace."
Today's New Testament reading comes from Philippians chapter 4. Over the last few weeks, we have been studying the book of Philippians. In conclusions to Paul's letter, he reassures us that the God of peace will always be with us.
"Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I will say rejoice. Let your reasonableness be known to everyone. The Lord is at hand. Do not be anxious about anything, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus."
Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things, what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Practice these things, and the God of peace will be with you.
When we need the God of peace, we need only to turn our eyes to him. Please stand and sing with us to worship God.
Abundant and free. Turn. In today's gospel reading, Jesus' disciples often do what we do. They look around at the circumstances of this world and let the storm shake their peace. But if Jesus can bring peace to the winds and the waves, how much peace can he bring to us? Please stand for the gospel reading.
On that day, when evening had come, he said to them, "Let us go across to the other side." And leaving the crowd, they took him with them in the boat, just as he was, and other boats were with him. And a great windstorm arose, and the waves were breaking into the boat, so that the boat was already filling. But he was in the stern, asleep on a cushion.
And they woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" And he awoke and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. He said to them, "Why are you so afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great fear and said to one another, "Who then is this that even the wind and the sea obey him?"
Go in peace and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Did he just say go in peace?
Do you think he forgot it's 2020?
Yeah, I haven't been at peace in like 8 months.
Do you think he was serious? There's a global pandemic, California's on fire, and murder hornets are apparently still a thing. Then the political climate of countries across the globe is terrifying. There's no way he was serious.
But he's a pastor.
Should we give it a try?
I guess. I mean, I'll try, but I think Pastor needs to find a new way to end the service until the world pulls itself together.
What are you doing?
Shh, we're at peace.
You're what?
Pastor said to go in peace, so we're at peace.
This isn't working. Oh good, I'm glad it's not just me.
Let's go check on the girls.
Any luck?
It didn't work for us.
I don't think Pastor was serious.
This is just...
Shh!
How can I be at peace when you guys are so chatty? Hey, do you guys have that math test today?
Yeah, I'm really stressed.
Hey, me too.
I think we need to study more to be at peace.
That sounds like a good plan.
Is it working for you?
Shh. Want to come with us to study for the math test?
You can't mention math and expect me to be at peace. All right, let's go. This isn't working.
Everybody, how's it going?
To be honest, Miss Croft, we're really struggling to be at peace.
What do you mean?
Well, Pastor said that we should be at peace, but that seems like a weird thing to say in 2020.
And then the boys wouldn't stop talking when I was trying to be at peace.
Hey, you're the one who brought up the math test.
And then they decided to get me stressed out about math, as if 2020 wasn't difficult enough. Now I have to worry about math.
Whoa, 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 everybody slow down. What do you think peace is?
Isn't it like laying down with your eyes closed or something?
I thought it was just sitting in silence.
I don't exactly know, but I know it doesn't involve chatter from these three.
Hey!
Peace also means no math, like none at all.
Okay, hold on, you guys. None of that is what real peace is. In fact, I was just talking with your classmates at home. Let's see what they have to say about peace.
Peace isn't based on your circumstances. Real peace can exist no matter what is going on in your life. That's because real peace only comes by being in the presence of God. That's the kind of peace that your soul craves.
In the work of Jesus, we have access to the presence of God 24/7. Anytime we feel stressed, anxious, or worried in any way, we can pray to God and ask Him to be with us.
Now, this doesn't mean we'll ever be stressed, anxious, or worried. We live in a very broken world, and these are realities that we'll always have to struggle with. If 2020 has taught us anything, it's taught us that trials and tribulations are very real.
But God offers us a peace that surpasses all understanding. So even when it doesn't make sense, even when it doesn't seem possible, even in the hardest of times, we can be at peace.
Whatever you're facing right now, take heart and be at peace. Pray to God and ask for His peace. He wants to give it to you. Remember, God sees you. God hears you. God is in control, and God is always at work.
So you're saying we can have peace in 2020?
Yes!
Even when we have a math test?
Yes!
Even when it feels like the world's on fire?
Yes, yes, yes.
Wow, I guess Pastor was right after all.
Hey, good morning. This is Coach Wilson. And I'm going to spend some time here with some students. And this is my chapel presentation, but I want to do it a little bit differently, being that we're in a COVID season. So I invited Vito, Brady, Logan, Jack, and Alex up on the stage to kind of do some discovery of what God's word says about His peace. The peace we find in the Bible that says a peace that surpasses all understanding. What do you think that means when he says a peace that surpasses all understanding, that will guard our hearts and minds? What do you think that means?
Well, something that just helps you get through your day, but unknowingly, like God just is there over your shoulder paying attention to you to make sure that you're okay.
That's awesome. That's awesome. So we're going to read a story right now. Then we're going to retell the story. Then we're going to talk about how we see God, Jesus, or his plan for peace in that story. Then we're going to identify a character or an event in that story that we can relate to. And then we're going to pray for obedience to go out and share that in our lives. And we go from there. So we're going to be reading from Matthew 14, 22 through 33. Who's going to read for me? All right, Alex has it. Go.
Immediately he made the disciples get into the boat and go before him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But the boat by this time was a long way from the land, beaten by the waves, for the wind was against them. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them, walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified and said, "It is a ghost." And they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus spoke to them, saying, "Take heart, it is I. Do not be afraid." And Peter answered him, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." So Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came to Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Jesus immediately reached out his hand and took hold of him, saying to him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" And when they got into the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshiped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God."
Thank you, Alex. That was a pretty awesome thing in order to see and to hear and to reread. So the first part of discovery for us, to discover where God's peace is or how we can find that, is retelling the story. So I need somebody to retell the story in your own words, not looking at it, but just kind of how you saw it unfold.
I'll do it. Well, I feel like it started with the crowds and Jesus ushering them away. And he went to the mountainside to pray. And he saw that the boat had already gone far out into the sea ocean. And he went to it, walked to him. And the disciples looked at him and said, "It's a ghost, because nobody can walk on water." So then the Lord said, "No, it's me." And the disciples said, "If it is you, prove it by telling me to come to you." And he did. As the disciple, Peter, walked to him, he saw the wind and the sea's waves, and he got scared and doubted Jesus's holiness, and he started sinking, and he said, "Help me," to Jesus, and Jesus did, but told him he had little faith.
Is there anything that someone wants to add? Maybe a part that stuck out to you that you want to add that maybe Vito left off? Anything?
Jesus said, when Peter doubted him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" I think that's really, really important, because in life we can't doubt Jesus. And we should always know that he has a plan for us.
Yeah, and I think it's a very human part to doubt, right? Especially when we see the winds and the waves and those kind of things happening. It's very human for us to doubt, because we are so in tune to our feelings and sensitivity. So the second part of discovery would be, what does this say about the peace of God, Jesus, or his plan for peace in our lives?
I would say that as long as you have faith in God and Jesus, he will always be there for you, and you can always know he is going to protect you no matter what happens, as long as you have faith. Because if you don't have faith, you will become like Peter and sink in the water or sink in whatever happens.
Thank you. Thank you. Brady?
I would say that because even though Peter doubted Jesus, God's peace always stays, and it never leaves, even when you don't have faith in him.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Logan, go ahead.
That's what I was going to kind of say. Since Peter had doubt in Jesus, God's peace will always give you a reason not to doubt in him.
That's good. That's really good. JL?
Yeah, I agree with them. When you have faith in God, you will always be lifted above. And he'll protect you and watch over you. But when you start to lose faith, you start to sink away. But Jesus will always be there for you still.
I think that's an important part that you picked up there, is that even though Peter failed in that moment to have faith, God was still there. And so when you talk about a peace that surpasses our understanding, it's a peace that comes when we least expect it. You know what I mean? Peter probably didn't expect that peace in that moment, but God still provided that. So as we continue to discover, what character or event in this story best describes you and why? I'll start with you, Logan.
I think Peter, because sometimes I'll have faith and I'll start walking in one direction, but then I might doubt a little bit because something didn't go the way I wanted. So I'll stop and maybe not go towards Jesus. But then Jesus will come back to me, giving me a reason why I should keep following him and follow the things that he wants for me.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Who else can add to that? What character or event best describes you and why?
I would go along the lines with Logan said. I would say Peter, because he doubted Jesus, that Jesus wouldn't be able to save him. And I think in life, we need to be able to trust Jesus, that he has a plan for us. And we should always trust him.
Thank you. Thank you. What about you, Brady?
I'll go with Peter, too, because in life, we'll always follow Jesus, but us humans as a whole will always sink down, and we might turn away from Jesus, but he'll always still believe in us, even when we don't believe in ourselves.
Yeah, and I would personally, me, identify sometimes in my life, and I would say the guys in the boat that didn't have the courage to get out of the boat. I see this great thing happening. And as much as we look at Peter's failure, Peter got out and did something about it. And so I often find myself just sitting in the boat, watching things happen and not really stepping out in Peter's position. So I don't get the chance to walk on water or fail like Peter did, because the guys in the boat didn't get that opportunity. So what about you, JL?
I think most of us are like Peter still, though, because like we all have faith and believe in Jesus and God. But like if something bad happens, like a family member dies, or you lose that faith and you start to go away from him.
Yeah, that's awesome. What about you, Vito?
Well, I don't want to be repetitive, but I also think I would be Peter, just going, but then losing faith if something wrong happens.
Awesome. Thank you guys for sharing. So the next part of discovery is obedience and sharing. Now, because we know who we identified with, now we have to ask ourselves, how can we better display the peace of God in our lives based on this story? What is something that we can do to display the peace of God better in our lives?
We can display the peace of God by going around and sharing the gospel with others that haven't heard it before, and maybe taking those people that haven't heard the good news of Jesus to church, and maybe they will become Christians.
I think that's awesome. And to remember Peter in that moment, or be in Peter in that moment, when they're not receptive to it or wanting to hear it, we can't begin to doubt that we're doing the right thing, right? Because that's like a storm when they go, I don't want to hear that. There's other ways to love them, you know, and so I appreciate that. What about you, Logan?
Well, if you can pray with them and let them, if they ask you why you have so much hope in God, and you can let them know that sometimes you lose faith because of something might happen, but you always go back to him because he has a better plan for you and everybody else in the world.
That's awesome. Thank you. Brady?
I would say just always keep pushing because whenever you're scared or anxious, and just know that God's peace is like armor, and it'll always be on you, and you can wear that armor with pride.
That's good. That's good. And that armor never leaves. There may be a storm or something like that, but I like the image of armor because it's around you and on you at all times. And so what doesn't change is that things outside you may change, but that armor doesn't change. It's still there. You just have to look down. You know, right? How about you, JL?
Yeah, like Brady said it perfect. God will never leave you no matter what. Like you can do something completely wrong and God's always going to be there with you. And like even things will leave you, but God's there.
That's awesome. So much revealed in God's word. Vito?
Well, going back to displaying it, I would say like even just doing the little things like holding the door for somebody, just like showing peace like to them, just being helpful and that kind of stuff, picking up trash off the floor, the little things.
That's awesome. And these are just things that we can do, simple things that we can do. We have a saying in my men's group, and it's called put the cart back. And it's something simple. When you go to the store and you see a cart, you put it back. But if you just do the little things in life, like he was just talking about, they add up and then they make a difference on the people that we affect by doing something positive. So thank you guys for sharing. We discovered God's word. Now we have to go out and be obedient in sharing this. And so that's going to be the prayer that Brady's going to lead us in, and then we'll close. For God's peace to be to God's peace and our obedience to live it and share it. You want to pray for that and pray us out?
Please bow your heads and pray with me. Dear God, thank you for blessing us with our wonderful lives and your wonderful peace that will always be with us. Thank you for giving us obedience and letting us strive in life. And thank you for just being the amazing God you are. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you guys for sharing. Appreciate it. Thank you, Faith Luther. God bless you.
Please pray with me. Dear Jesus, thank you for being our Prince of Peace. Thank you for allowing us to have access to your presence so that we can have peace despite our circumstances. Please be with us as we go throughout our day and grant us peace as we experience the trials and tribulations of this world. Most of all, thank you for loving us in your holy and precious name. Amen.
Now may our Lord, Jesus Christ himself, and God our Father, who loved us and gave us eternal comfort and good hope, through grace, comfort your hearts, and establish them in every good work and word. Dear friends, go in peace. Amen.